The transverse flute is of the common kind used in Carnatic music. It is interesting to see the North Indian flutes being longer than the South Indian flutes. The flutes of varying sizes of different makes are a treat to watch. Kumbakonam occupies an important place in the flute map of India. The blinded teenage boy of Kumbakonam gave a fresh lease life to the art of playing flute in the Carnatic music way back in the 19th century. This blind boy was none other than Sarabesa Sastri, who was a child prodigy from Kumbakonam. Sarabesa Sastri was born in Kumbakonam in the present-day state of Tamil Nadu. The misfortune of being blinded in a childhood had never come in his way of becoming a legend. Experimenting and evolving new styles and techniques of playing flute has made a permanent name for himself in the field.
Sarabesa Sastri is my uncle and is a born genius in playing flute. The greatness of Sarabesa Sastri is he did not have any guru. Sarabesa Sastri used to make his own flute from the bamboo tree grown in their own residential compound. The rarity of him is about his grasping of subject at one instant. The traditional disciples of Sarabesa Sastri are still in limelight today.
சஞ்சீவி ராவுங்கிறவர் அவருடைய பிரதான சிஷ்யர். அவருடைய அவர்கிட்ட அப்படியே 100% அவருடைய கலையை வாங்கிட்டவர் சஞ்சீவி ராவ். அவர் நியர்பை 60 or 70 வரைக்கும் தான் சஞ்சீவி ராவ் இருந்திருக்க. ஆனால் சஞ்சீவி ராவோட சிஷியர்கள்லாம் இப்ப இருக்காங்க. ஸோ தட் இஸ் சரபசா சாஸ்திரியுடைய சிஷியருக்கு சிஷியர்கள் இப்பவும் இருக்காங்க. அந்த சிஷியர்கள்
at a very young age சரபசா சாஸ்திரி had the distinction of playing entire range of Indian ragas on flute. The fingering techniques invented by Sarabesa Sastri were highly scientific and accurate as a keyboard. Even the minute oscillations required for the intricate gamakas of Carnatic music were covered by his fingering system. By the turn of the 19th century, Sarabesa Sastri played flute from simple tunes to full-fledged krutis, and thus flute came into limelight as par with veena as a concert instrument. Sarabesa Sastri, like many great geniuses, lived a short life. After Sarabesa Sastri left for heavenly abode, his most trusted and celebrated disciple, Palladam Sanjeeva Rao, who perfected an elaborated fingering system, popularized flute as a solo concert instrument. Palladam Sanjeeva Rao lived as undisputed king of Carnatic flute for over 6 decades. Sri Mahalingam, who was also known as Mali, never had any formal training of flute playing, but at a very young age he was identified as a child prodigy and in the later years became one of the greatest geniuses in Carnatic tradition.
If you don't have good words, you use your fingers. உத்திலேயும் மாடிக்கு வேல் நடிசை பரல் இல்லாதவனுக்கு விரல் தட் இஸ் தமிழ் சேயிங் ஆல்சோ அல்டிமேட்லி ஸோ ஹேப்பன்ஸ் தட் வென் யூ ஆர் நாட் ஏபிள் டு சிங் வெல் யூ டேக் டு சம் மியூசிக் ஐ கம் டு சம் இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட் ஆன் விச் மை ஹார்ட் ஒர்க் அண்ட் ட்ரைனிங் யூ கேன் ரீப்ரொடியூஸ் வாட் யூ வாண்ட் டு சிங் அல்டிமேட்லி கீதா வாத்திய நிறைய Gita Anusarana is Vadya. Vadya Anusarana is Nritya. When you say Gita Anusarana is Vadya, if someone sings Nagamamu and you play it on your flute Nagamamu, The listener will say, Nagumomu, oh, you played well. Actually, I have not spelled the sahitya of the song. So that's how the Gita influences the Vaidya. And Mahaniya went far ahead of making his route as a carrier of vocal music, which is easier said than done. I mean, to have a vocal approach on an instrument is the ultimate dream of every instrumentalist.
H. Ramachandra, a staunch devotee of Sarabasastri, carried the tradition unstinted as a soloist. His contemporary, Mahalingam, who was dominating the scene, all but erased the bani of Sarabasastri from the public memory. Ramachandra, who had spent more than 25 years with his guru Sarabasastri, retained all through his life, from changing the traditional style of playing flute, but appreciated the effort and techniques of Sri Mahalingam. Dr. N. Ramani, today, living legend and a disciple of Sri Mahalingam, became top-ranked flutist of modern era. Dr. Ramani was born in Tiruvayur in Tamil Nadu, the birthplace of Tyagaraja, Muthuswami Dikshita and Shyama Sastri, the Trinity. Dr. Ramani had the distinction of dueting with Hindustani flutist Hariprasad Chaurasia, and his jugal bandis included his partnership with Dr. Balamurli Krishna, Pandit Jasraj, violinist T.N. Krishna and sarodist Amjad Ali Khan. Dr. Ramani became the first flutist to get wider recognition in India and abroad exclusively for his classical purity and vocal quality of his flute playing.
The octaves to play in the flute, it is in the medium octave, the instrument. Flute is actually set up just like a restaurant. Like that. This gives only octaves, the octaves purpose. But for our music to give our, most of the songs were in Arigami scale and the Gararapya scale and the Sangrabharman scale. So this Tyagaraja, basically Tyagaraja songs. For sometimes, you know, the violin player also playing the octaves like that. For example, this for this sagam, they are playing from this sagam. Up to that, the violin player can play. If I want to play more octaves after that, I have to change the flute in smaller flute or bigger. So that advantage is having in our instrument flute. So that is why I made it in future little by little to increase, to play the ragas and one octave low. For example, if you are playing three flutes or four flutes together, so it helps to play, to cover all octaves, not only octaves, and just like this sangadis, which vocal rendering is possible to produce in the flute. It will be helpful for the future generations to play. For example, one raga I take Sanmopriya. This flute I can play this limitation. These are all false notes. Up to pa you can play, but here you cannot give detailed things. That is why take other sajjam, panjamam sajjam, if you have it.
Mm-hmm.
up to that you can play. So you can have a wide circulation of possibility to play in the instrument. I took the pattern of the vocal style of approaching concert pattern. That includes raga playing, swara playing, and a song rendering, like that. So that it is easy to follow for everybody to play more interesting.
The legacy of this legend still carries in his family with the same devotion.
First of all, I'm really fortunate to be under the guidance and tutelage of Ramani sir. Moreover, he's a great teacher. Like, he teaches all the tough techniques in a very simple way that every student can, a mediocre student as well as a really good student can understand. Moreover, flute playing is really tough and he makes it look so easy. But the moment we try it, it's not coming off flute at all. But as we continue to learn from him, like we are grasping all the techniques, he makes it so easy to play it. Even the tougher player styles in the flute, which he innovated, he's making it very easy to
N.S. Srinivasan from Andhra Pradesh, who is contemporary to Dr. Ramani, has his own style and presentation which made him very popular not only down south but in rest of India.
Gita is the first one. Gita, Vadya, Pritya.